Hello students, today we are going to read a third chapter from Hornbill book, class 11, Discovering Tut, the saga continues. This chapter is written by A.R. Williams. This is the chapter about the last successor of the powerful destiny of Tutankhamun, who died when he was a teenager. After ruling for 9 years, he died in a mysterious way. This chapter throws light over all the possible mysteries, the curse, where his tomb lies, his life and untimely death. Egyptians believed that there is life after death, and that is the reason why the pharaohs were buried with wealth and everyday use items. Let's see the explanation of this chapter. He was just a teenager when he died, the last heir of the powerful destiny. Family and had ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries. He was led to dust laden with gold and eventually forgotten. Since the discovery of his tomb in 1922, the modern world has speculated about what happened to him, with murder being the most extreme possibility. Now, leaving his tomb for the first time in almost 80 years, Tut was undergone a CT scan that offers new clues about his life and death and provides precise data for an accurate forensic reconstruction of the boy's pharaoh. Let's see the word meanings. Heir means successor. Laden means covered. Speculated means made many ideas. Tomb means a place where a dead person is buried. Forensic reconstruction means the process of recreating the face of an individual. Pharaoh means king. Tutankhamun, also known as Tut, was a teenager when he died. He was the last heir of his powerful dynasty, which ruled Egypt and its empire for centuries. He was laid on rest, heavily covered with gold. His tomb was discovered in 1922, which made the world raise a question about what happened to him and whether he had been murdered. After almost 80 years, his body was about to undergo a CT scan, which would give new information and clues about his life and death. His face would be recreated with the help of a procedure called forensic reconstruction. Let's read the next para. An angry wind stirred up ghostly dust devils as King Tut was taken from his resting place. Resting place means his tomb. In the ancient means old Egyptian cemetery. Cemetery means graveyard, known as the Valley of Kings. Dark valley. Cloud. Dark valley means dark colored clouds had scudded. Scudded means moving quickly. The desert sky all day and now were veiling. Veiling means covered. The stars in casket gray. Casket gray here is sky. It was 6 p.m. on 5 January 2005. The world's most famous mummy glided head first into a CT scanner brought here to probe. Probe means inquire into. The lingering means long lasting, that were in the mind of the people, not solved. Medical mysteries means secret. His little understood young ruler who died more than 3,300 years ago. A fast, strange, and unnatural wind was blowing as King Tut's
body was taken from his grave called Valleys of King. This was an ancient Egyptian graveyard. Dark clouds moved quickly across the desert all day long, and later they covered the stars. Means stars were not visible in the sky. On January 5, 2005 at 10 p.m., King Tut's mummy, which is the world's most famous mummy, was placed in the CT scanner to investigate the mystery behind his death, which had occurred more than 3,300 years ago. Means when his mummy was taken out from his graveyard, a storm came. Let's see the next para. All afternoon, the usual line of tourists from around the world had descended. Descended means came down. Yeah, gathered there into the cramped. Cramped means very small, 2 feet into choti si rock cut tomb, some 26 feet underground, to pay their respect. They gazed all the murals. Gazed means stared, look into fixed direction. Mural means paintings on the wall of the burial chamber. Chamber means room where he was buried. And peered at Tut's gilded face. Gilded means gold covered face. The most striking feature of his mummy shaped outer coffin lid. Some visitors read from guidebooks in a whisper. Whisper means to speak slowly so that others can't listen. Others stood silently, perhaps pondering. Pondering means thinking. Tut's untimely death in his late teens, or wondering with a shiver. Shiver means fear here, means to shake with fear. If the Faroj curse, Faroj means king, Faroj curse, death or misfortune falling upon those who disturb him was really true. Let's see the explanation. All afternoon, tourists visited the 26 feet deep underground rock-cut tomb to pay respect to the king. Many people stopped, went into the small tomb and looked in admiration at the murals. Means they saw the murals, paintings which was done on the walls, and appreciated them, and took a look at the face of Tut that had been painted with, that was covered with gold. While visitors read the guidebooks in a whispery tone, some stood silently. They were thinking about the untimely death of his king, of their kings. They might also be thinking if the curse of the pharaoh, which leads to the descent of the misfortune upon the person who disturbed him, is true. It means the person who has disturbed him, a curse may come to them because they have disturbed them from their resting place. The mummy is in very bad condition because of what Carter did in the 1920s, said Jahi Hawass. Now who is the Jahi Hawass? He is the Secretary General of Egypt's Supreme Council of Antiquities. As she leaned over the body for a long first look, Carter Howard Carter, that is, was the British archaeologist who in 1922 discovered Tut's tomb after years of futile searching. Futile means vain, worth, bekar. It is content, though hastily ransacked in antiquity. Hastily means fast, swiftly. Ransacked means raid. Raid girana, matlab kisi cheez ko nikalna, churana. Were surprisingly complete. They remain the richest royal collection ever found and have become part of the pharaoh's legend. Stunning artifacts in gold, their eternal brilliance mean to guarantee resurrection. Stunning means surprising. Artifacts means life. Artifacts means jewelry. And resurrection means rebirth. caused a sensation at the time of the discovery and still get the most attention, but Tut was also buried with everyday things he would want in the afterlife. Afterlife means life after death. Board game, a bronze razor, linen undergarments, cases of food and wine. Let's see the explanation. Jai Hawass, who was the Secretary General of Egypt, he bent over the body to see him. He said that the mummy was in very bad condition because of the act of British archaeologist Howard Carter, who took out the body in 1920s. He discovered King Tut's tomb in 1922 after a long search. The valuable treasures of Tut had been explored earlier too, but surprisingly they were complete. The treasure found at Tut's grave is the richest till date and has come to be known as the Pharaoh's legend. It has artifacts in gold which were eternally beautiful and as good as new. Such artifacts still get attention. Tut was buried with things of daily use like a razor made of bronze, games, linen undergarments and boxes of food and wine which he could use in the next life. Means Tut was buried. Tut ko sari un cheezon ke sath dafnaya gaya jo ki after life mein unko zarurat ho sakti hai, because Egyptians believe in after life. Let's see the next para. After months of carefully recording the Pharaoh's funerary treasures, Carter began investigating his three nested coffin. Nested means three layer coffin. Funerary treasure means treasure, the valuable things with which the king was buried, means the things which were put in his coffin. Opening the first, he found a shroud. Shroud means coffin. Adorned means decorated with garlands of willow and olive leaves, wild celery, lotus petals and corn flowers, the fated evidence of a burial in March and April. When he finally reached the mummy, though he ran into trouble, the ritual regimes had hardened, cementing Tut to the bottom of his solid gold coffin. No amount of legitimate force could move them. Carter wrote later, what was to be done? Let's see. Beta, here resin is a sticky substance with which something is hardened or pasted. Okay, let's see the explanation. Carter took a few months to record the treasures found in Tut's grave. Then he began inquiring his three coffins which were nested one in another. Matlab ek ke baad ek teen coffin rakhe hue the. In the first coffin he found a piece of cloth with garlands of willow, olive leaves, wild celery, lotus petals and corn flower, which suggested that he had been buried in the months of March and April. When he reached the third coffin, he was in trouble. The body had hardened due to the resin which had cemented the body, and it had stuck to the bottom of the coffin which was made of gold. Carter wondered what to do next, because no amount of force could separate the two. Means uski body us bottom se bilkul bhi alag nahi ho rahi thi, wo bahut hi hard ho gayi thi, wo resin bahut hard ho gaya tha. कार्टर को समझ नहीं आ रहा था बॉडी को उस कॉफिन से कैसे निकाला जाए. द सन कैन बीट डाउन लाइक ए हैमर दिस फार साउथ इन इजिप्ट एंड कार्टर ट्राई टू यूज इट टू लूजन द रेजिन्स फॉर सेवरल आवर्स. रेजिन मीन्स मैंने आपको बताया था दिस इज गोल्ड गोंद. ही सेट द मम्मी Outside in blazing sunshine, that heated it to 149 degrees Fahrenheit. Nothing buzzed. Blazing means very hot. Buzzed means moved, shifted. लेकिन कुछ नहीं हुआ, कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ा. He reported with scientific detachment. Detachment means separation. मतलब साइंटिफिक अटैचमेंट का सहारा नहीं लिया उसने, साइंटिफिक डिटैचमेंट की बात कर रहा है. दैट द कंसोलिडेटेड मटेरियल हैड टू बी चिजल्ड अवे. चिजल्ड अवे मीन्स टू कट समथिंग विद ए चिजल, मीन्स आरे जैसा कुछ होता है उससे काटना. From beneath the limbs and trunk, before it was possible to raise the king's remains, Carter tried to loosen the resin. मतलब उसे melt करने की कोशिश की. By keeping the body into the hot sun, he kept the mummy in 149 Fahrenheit degrees heat for several hours, but still it remained stuck. It didn't separate it. Didn't separate. He reported that a chisel could be used to cut down the mummy from the limbs and the trunk so that Tut's body could be taken out of the coffin. In his defense, Carter really had little choice. If he hadn't cut the mummy free, thieves most certainly would have circumvented the guards and ripped it apart to remove the gold. In Tut's time, the royals were fabulously rich. Fabulously means very much. Circumvented means find a way, arrives. मतलब कुछ पता लगा लेना, चीट करना. ओके. एंड दे फोर थॉट और होप्ड दे कुड टेक देयर रिचेस विद देम फॉर हिज जर्नी टू द ग्रेट बियॉन्ड. किंग टट वाज लेविश्ड विद ग्लिटरिंग गुड्स. Lavished means decorated, means stuffed. With glittering means shining goods. Precious collars. Precious means valuable. Inlaid necklace. Inlaid means a decorative pattern on a surface. And bracelets. Rings. Amulets. Amulet is also an ornament or small piece of jewelry, which is put around the neck to give protection against evil, danger or disease. A ceremonial apron, sandals, sheaths for his fingers and toes, and the now iconic inner coffin and mask, all of pure gold, two separate from his adornment. Adornment means ornaments, decorative things. Carter's man removed the mummy's head and severed nearly every major joint. Once they had finished, they reassembled the remains on a layer of sand in a wooden box with padding that concealed the damage. Conceal means hid. The bed where Tut now rests. According to the Carter, he had no choice other than to cut the mummy. He believed that if he hadn't done that, thieves would have removed the gold from the tomb and would have looted it, would have robbed it. During Tut's time, the royal people were very wealthy and rich, and they had a belief that they would take rebirth after death. They could take the wealth along with them. For his life after that, he has given valuable collars, necklace with decorative patterns, bracelets, rings, amulets, ceremonial aprons, sandals, sheets for fingers and toes, and now an iconic inner coffin and a mask. His man removed his head and every joint of his body. After they finished, they reassembled the remains in a wooden box with padding filled with a layer of sand to conceal the damage. It was his new resting place. Now let's read next. Archaeology has changed substantially in the intervening decades. Intervening means occur in the time between events, focusing less on treasure and more on the fascinating means attractive details of the life and intriguing mysteries of death. Intriguing means to arouse one's curiosity. Means uljhi hui. Mysteries means secrets. It also uses more sophisticated tools, including medical technology. In 1968, more than 40 years after Carter's discovery, an anatomy professor x-rayed the mummy and revealed a startling fact. Startling means choka dene wala, surprising fact. Beneath the resin, beneath means under, resin is a dead substance with which they pasted the body that cakes his chest. His breastbone and front ribs are missing. In the past few decades, archaeology has changed as it now focuses on the details of life and the mysteries of death. Earlier, it was about focusing on the treasure. Now, it uses more advanced medical technologies and tools for research. In 1968, an anatomy professor x-rayed King Tut's mummy and revealed that the front limbs and breastbone are missing. Today, diagnostic imaging can be done with computed tomography or CT, by which hundreds of x-rays in cross sections are put together like slices of bread to create a three-dimensional virtual body. What more would a CT scan reveal of Tut than the X-ray? And could it answer two of the biggest questions still lingering about him? Lingering means demise, means death, and lingering means that is also unsolved. How did he die? And how old was he at the time of his death? Now, with the advancement of technology, CT scan or computed tomography can give a virtual image of the whole body. With the help of this technology, King Tut's body would be scanned to find answers of two questions. How did he die? And how old was he at the time of his death? King Tut's demise was a big event. Even by royal standard, he was the last of his family's line, and his funeral was the death rattle of a dynasty. But the particulars of his passing away and its aftermath are unclear. His death was a shock to the royals, to the kings also, as he was the last person of his family, and his funeral pointed the diminishment of his dynasty. Means his dynasty finished with the death of Tut. However, what happened after his death is still not clear. It is also a mystery. Amenhotep III, Tut's father or grandfather, was a powerful pharaoh who ruled for almost four decades at the height of the 18th dynasty's golden age. His son Amenhotep IV succeeded him and initiated one of the strangest periods in the history of ancient Egypt. The new pharaoh promoted the worship of the Aten, the sun disk, changed his name to Akhenaten, or servant of the Aten, and moved the religious capital from the old city of Thebes to the new city of Akhenaten, known now as Amarna. He further shocked the country by attacking Amun, a major god, smashing his image. Smashing means hitting, means images ko tod fod diya, and closing his temples. It must have been a horrific time. Horrific means very bad, said Ray Johnson, director of the University of Chicago's Research Center in Luxor. The site of ancient Thebes, the family had ruled for centuries, was coming to an end. And then Akhenaten went a little wacky. Wacky means सन की क्रेजी यू कैन से. लेट्स सी द एक्सप्लेनेशन ऑफ दिस पैरा. टेड्स फादर और ग्रैंड फादर एमेनहोटप थर्ड वॉज ए वेरी पावरफुल फैरो हु रूल्ड ओवर ए पीरियड ऑफ 40 ईयर्स. हिज सन एमेनहोटप फोर्थ सक्सेडेड हिम एंड बिगेन द स्ट्रेंजेस्ट पीरियड इन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इजिप्ट. ही प्रोमोटेड द वर्शिप ऑफ एटन. ही चेंज हिज नेम टू अखेनाटन. Meaning, its meaning is servant of Athens. Athens is a god. He also shifted the religious capital from Thebes to the new city of Akhenaten, called Amarna. Further, he attacked Amun, a god, smashed his images and closed his temples. Ray Johnson, director of the University of Chicago, said, "It must have been a bad time for the empire as the family who ruled for centuries came to an end and Akhenaten moved in an odd direction." Means वो अजीब सी direction में चल रहा था and ऐसा लगता था कि he became crazy. What is the need of breaking old temples or the images of the gods? After Akhenaten's death, a mysterious ruler named Samenkhare appeared briefly and exited with hardly a trace. And then a very young Tutankhamun took the throne. Throne means singhasan, crown. A King Tut, as he is widely known today, the boy king soon changed his name to Tutankhamun, leaving image of Amun, and oversaw this restoration of the old age. He reigned for about 9 years and then died unexpectedly. Another mysterious ruler, Samenkhare, succeeded him and died soon. Next, Tutankhamun, who is a Tut, sat on the throne and ruled for 9 years. He worshipped God Amun in the old age and however, he died mysteriously. Regardless of his time, his fame and speculations about his fate, Tut is one mummy among many in Egypt. How many? No one knows. The Egyptians' mummy project, which began an inventory means list, in late 2003, has recorded almost 600 so far and is still counting. The next phase, scanning the mummies with a portable CT machine donated by the National Geographical Society and Siemens. Its manufacturer, who is the manufacturer of CT scan? Siemens. King Tut is one of the first mummies to be scanned in death as in life, moving legally ahead of his countrymen. Tut is one of the mummies in Egypt. Means it was very famous and there were so many ideas about his fate. And then how many mummies are there in Egypt? No one knows. The Egyptian mummy project, which began a list in late 2003, has recorded almost 600 mummies so far and now still is counting at that time. King Tut's mummy was the first one to be CT scanned. Under the next phase of scanning the mummies with the machine donated by the National Geographic Society and Siemens. This machine was donated by this society. A CT machine scanned the mummy head to toe, creating 1,700 digital X-ray image in cross section. Tut's head scanned in 0.62 millimeters slices to register its intricate means ekdam ulji hui si, theek hai, in structure. Takes an eerie detail, eerie means strange detail, in resulting image. With Tut's entire body similarly recorded, a team of specialists in radiology फोरेंसिक एंड एनाटॉमी, एनाटॉमी मीन्स मानव विज्ञान, जिसमें ह्यूमन बॉडी के स्ट्रक्चर की स्टडी की जाती है, डेट इज कॉल्ड एनाटॉमी। बिगिन टू प्रॉब, प्रॉब मीन्स इंक्वायरी इनटू, सर्च करना। ओके, द सीक्रेट दैट द विंग्ड गॉडेस ऑफ ए गिल्डेड बरियल श्राइन प्रोटेक्टेड फॉर सो लॉन्ग। बरियल मीन्स बरिंग द डेड। द सिटी स्कैन मशीन स्कैन द बॉडी बाय क्रिएटिंग 1700 डिजिटल एक्सरेज इन क्लोज सेक्शन। टट्स हेड वॉज स्कैंड इन 0.62 मिलीमीटर स्लाइसिस टू रिकॉर्ड द टाइनी डिटेल्स। द रिजल्टिंग इमेज वॉज वेरी स्ट्रेंज। ए टीम ऑफ रेडियोलॉजी, फोरेंसिक एंड एनाटॉमी एक्सपर्ट्स स्टार्टेड एग्जामिनिंग द सीक्रेट्स ऑफ द ग्रेव डेट हैड बीन प्रोटेक्टेड बाय फ्लाइंग गॉडेसेस फॉर ए लॉन्ग टाइम। मीन्स इट द बॉडी ऑफ द डेड वॉज प्रोटेक्टेड बाय द फ्लाइंग गॉडेसेस। इट वॉज थॉट द नाइट ऑफ द स्कैन वर्कमैन कैरी टट फ्रॉम द टूम्ब इन हिज बॉक्स लाइक पाल बियर्स। पाल बियर्स क्या होते हैं? पाल बियर्स आर द पर्सन हु हैज टू एस्कॉर्ट ए कॉफिन एट ए फ्यूनरल, मतलब जो कंधे देते हैं, ठीक है, जो बॉडी को, दे आर कॉल्ड पाल बियर्स। दे क्लाइम्ड ए रैम्प एंड ए फ्लाइट ऑफ स्टेयर्स इन टू द स्वर्लिंग सैंड। स्वर्लिंग सैंड क्या है? यहाँ पे आंधी आ गई थी वहाँ पे, तो स्वर्लिंग सैंड घूम रही थी सैंड वहाँ पे, मतलब ऐसे ही बहुत सैंड उड़ रही थी। देन रोज ऑन ए हाइड्रोलिक लिफ्ट इन टू द ट्रेलर डेट हेल्ड द स्कैनर। 20 मिनट्स लेटर टू मैन इमर्ज स्प्रिंटेड फॉर एन ऑफिस नियर बाय एंड रिटर्न विद ए पेयर ऑफ वाइट प्लास्टिक फैंस। स्वर्लिंग मीन्स ट्विस्ट। हाइड्रोलिक लिफ्ट क्या होती है? ये लिफ्ट जिसमें मशीन को लिफ्ट या मूव करने के लिए को एक प्रेशर यूज किया जाता है। स्प्रिंटेड मीन्स रन एट ए हाई स्पीड। एंड स्प्रिंटेड फॉर एन ऑफिस नियर बाय एंड रिटर्न विद ए पेयर ऑफ वाइट प्लास्टिक फैंस। द मिलियन डॉलर स्कैनर हैड क्विट बिकॉज ऑफ सैंड इन ए कूलर फैन। कर्स ऑफ द फेरो, जॉग्ड ए गार्ड नर्वसली। During the night, workmen climbed up on the ramp and the flight of the stairs to carry the body from the tomb into the spinning sand outside. They rose the body onto a hydraulic lift, then into a trailer where the scanner was kept. After 20 minutes, two men ran. After 20 minutes later, two men emerged, sprinted for an office nearby. He returned with a pair of white plastic fans. The million dollar scanner. Sorry. After 20 minutes, two men ran towards the office nearby to bring two fans. The scanner was not working as the sand had entered a cooler fan. The guard joked that it was because of the curse of the pharaoh because they had removed his body. Means they have removed the body, that's why a storm started to come, and a guard said that it is the curse of the pharaoh because they have disturbed the body. Let's see the next para. Eventually the substitute fan worked well enough to finish the procedure. After checking that no data had been lost, the technicians turned over to the workman, who carried him back to his tomb. Less than 3 hours after he was removed from his coffin, the pharaoh again rested in peace, where the funerary priest had led him go so long ago. Once the fence worked, the procedure was finished. The data was checked in case of any losses, or then technicians returned the body to the palpiers, who carried him back to the tomb. In less than 3 hours, he was resting at the same place where the priest had laid him many years ago. Back in the trailer, a technician pulled up an astonishing image of Tut on a computer screen. A gray head took shape from a scattering of pixels, and the technicians spun and tilted it in every direction. Neck vertebrae appeared as clearly as in an anatomy class. Other images revealed a hand, several views of the ribcage, and a transection of the skull, but for now the pressure was off. Sitting back in his chair, Chai Hawa smiled, visibly relieved that nothing had gone seriously wrong. "I did not sleep last night, not for a second," he said. "I was so worried, but now I think I will go and sleep." In the trailer, the technician showed a beautiful image of Tut on a computer screen. He showed the gray head, which was scattered in pixels, and he spun it around. Next, the vertebrate hand, rib cage, and transection of his skull was shown. As the work was done, the pressure was finally off from the shoulders of Chai Hawass. While sitting in his chair, he smiled and said that he was relieved and nothing went wrong. He had not slept the previous night, and now, as the work was done, he would go and sleep. By the time he left the trailer, descending metal stairs to the sandy ground, the wind had stopped. The winter air lay cold and still, like death itself, in this valley of the departed. Just above the entrance to Tut's tomb stood Orion, the constellation that the ancient Egyptians knew as the soul of Osiris, the god of the afterlife, watching over the boy king. By the time they left the trailer, the wind had stopped and the winter air was like death itself, means it was very cold, very chill. Just above the tomb, the Orion constellation shone in the night sky, watching over the boy king. It was considered that Osiris is the god of afterlife. That's all. Thank you for listening this video as well as watching.